What's up everyone? I'm sorry that my music went a bit too loud in the other video about the single records, but I promise that I will turn the music volume a bit down in my future videos. Thanks for telling me. Your opinion means a lot to me to help improve my videos. In this video, we'll talk about picking the right record for doubles. So I'm just sitting here with this fancy blue and pink record, and that's actually a quite cool record. If you want to check out some of my other cool records, you can check out in the link in the description. All right, let's get into it. So picking the right record for doubles is crucial if we want to play a lot of doubles and you want to get the extra advantage. Actually, the record can have a huge impact on the outcome of a match. What you should know about the record is that there is three things that matters when it comes to record. We have something called the balance. Is it head heavy or head light? For example, if we try to measure this record, it is actually head light. That means it will tip towards the grip. Then also we do have something called the weight. Basically how much does this racket weigh? Then we have something called stiffness, which is how much is this racket actually able to bend. That is the things we want to discuss in this video. And hopefully I can give you some tools to go out and decide what racket is best for you. But before we get started, let's take a look at the double game to find out what is our needs when going to play double. In double, there is a lot of fast-paced game that can be flat games and a lot of covering on the net. So basically, there is a lot of things about moving the racket very, very fast. So what we need is a high acceleration and being able to, you know, hit and get ready for the next row all the time. Don't want to have a heavy racket because that basically will slow our racket movement down. And it's also the case if we decide to have a head heavy racket. A head heavy racket gives us more power when we hit, but it will decrease our ability to move the racket very fast around. So what we need is a head light racket where the weight is towards the grip. But why should I not pick a racket where I can hit some hard smashes from the rear court playing doubles? That is because most points when you are playing double is won from the middle court towards the net. You basically want to feel agile with your racket. You should be able to move your racket fast around. Great. So what about the stiffness? That's the last thing we want to talk about. Stiffness is your racket's ability to bend, as we can see here. And the stiffness will basically help you each time or limit you each time you are hitting the stroke. If you are a beginner to intermediate, benefit a lot from having a flexible to medium flexible racket because it will give you more power each time you hit the stroke. It will kind of give you this trendline effect, like, or whiplash effect, call it whatever you want. But if you are an advanced player, you need to be able to generate a lot of power on your upper body if you want this whiplash effect to kick in. Let's say that you are going to perform a lift or something like that, and each time you hit, the racket will bend and add up more power to your stroke. So when you are performing a lift with a stiff racket, the racket will not bend and you'll be able to control it much more. But when you want to hit with power, it will still manage to flex. And I'm sure you can find videos on YouTube that where you can see this flexible in action. Jonathan from Swift Badminton also had a nice video where he actually showed this in slow motion. Take a look at that. So my choice for double players regarding the racket would be to have head light racket, but also some kind of a light racket. When I say a light racket, I would say from 75 to 85. Grand. The stiffness of the racket should be dependable to your skill. If you are an advanced player and just looking for a racket and stop by my channel to get some casual tips, try to find a stiff racket because you'll benefit more from that. If you are an intermediate to beginner, I would recommend you having a flexible to medium flexible racket because that will give you more power when you are playing. So my safe choice for double player, light racket, head light racket, and medium flex. So in the description I found some rackets that is suitable for double games and you will also be able to buy them, so take a look at that. Also, I will be live in the comment section and try to answer your questions about how to decide the right racket. You are free to ask any questions and I will do my best to answer them. consider to watch the single record selection as well. Subscribe if you haven't done it already, hit the like button again and again, and do it with all of my videos. That's just how YouTube works. Consider to become a member on Shovel Life. Remember that I do this all for free, for you to enjoy giving out some tips. So if you want to give anything back, then you can support me on Shovel Life by becoming a member, clicking the join button below the video. So that's it for me. Have a nice weekend.